down and get up. But if you're too low, you need to get up, it's always a hassle. So I just go up high so I can get this. So, here I am. And I know I'm too high because I'm just kind of seeing how I add up to it. A little too high. Let's get her down. And that's fine. So, now, he's on his tooth device. Since we never want to introduce any kind of shock load onto a tooth device, my goal is to put him on you to center.
Okay, what is
sternum? How would you describe the angle?
suspicion of correctly kind of.
So the soft one is
ventral to ventral. The heart connect, which should be pre-set up so that you don't forget that. Just rig it like this so it's there. Come in and put the chest.
Because you're going to take Mark fully off of his ropes.
So that's my next step. I have one point of contact, so I took him off his ASAP, because this is his second.
Okay, so the flexible, the one that's flexed right now, that's the back lat.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, so now all I got to do is lower him onto me.
Lower him onto your descent device.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. Okay, there he is. Now this device is not required, but I'm showing you the extra friction portion because of your devices. You take care of it, you redirect the ropes to your side position immediately. Not these gear loops, not the seat gear loops. Now I can come down after I've made sure my ASAP is not in the lock position, because that can suck to have two people loading an ASAP.
Right. You've got no extra weight on it.
No, I don't feel it. Now, if I come down a little more, you can see, let's say here's the paramedic right here. And I'm like, all right, I'm out of here. See ya. Disconnected from the scene. And at that point, I just want to set it up like this.
Yeah.
It might be a couple of minutes, you know. I might just be tired. I might just need to drink.
Yeah, maybe you should microphone.
But if that is a platform that you need to still be tied off at, he's still tied off, which is the nice thing about being able to escape the system without having to re-rig anything.